just an amazing night of music, and I'm just going to be a footnote. I'm just going to keep it nice and short. Some people requested a couple of songs, some songs of mine that I've played in the past a few times. And like I said before to some folks, the I'm just going to do quick five songs. Fifth song is anyone is welcome to come along and play a little bit on it, because it's an easy song to play along on. It's called French Telephone, and it's in E minor, and so it's easy. Anyway, this first song is dedicated, see you around. First song is dedicated to anybody who has ever had a crush on a teacher. I don't know if anybody's ever been in that situation. I had a crush on several teachers, and so I had to sort of put them all together into this one character named Miss Mahoney. Miss Mahoney drives an old beat-up Mustang, and she smells like patchouli, and she's my teacher. Fifth grade was stupid, but sixth grade's cool, and it's all because of Miss Mahoney. Once she told us that the Earth was a perfect place, 'cause it's just the perfect distance from the sun. While I agree about the Earth being perfect, but I think it's perfect for another reason. What makes it perfect? What makes the whole world perfect is Miss Mahoney. Miss Mahoney, what makes it perfect? What makes the whole world perfect is Miss Mahoney, yeah. Just this morning, Miss Mahoney came to school, looking pretty as a picture in her peasant shirt and blue jeans. Her smile was bigger and more beautiful than ever. Don't tell anybody I love Miss Mahoney. Then in the middle of a lesson on ecology, she just blurted it out. She's getting married. Getting married, Miss Mahoney's getting married. Might as well just run me over with a big old school bus, 'cause what makes it perfect? What makes the whole world perfect is Miss Mahoney. Miss Mahoney, what makes it perfect? What makes the whole world perfect is Miss Mahoney, yeah. Miss Mahoney, yeah. Miss Mahoney, yeah.
Thank you.
You were lucky. My teachers were horror shows.
I had a Miss Mahoney.
I guess,
a,
yeah.
I had a beautiful Miss Mahoney.
It could go either way, I guess.
Oh, my God. What a collection.
Oh my gosh. Well, here's a song about being up in the middle of the night and thinking about someone you love.
Miss Mahoney.
Exactly. I'm just going to keep playing Miss Mahoney over and over with a different introduction.
Five times, right?
Exactly. This one's called Breaking. It ain't funny. From where the stars are hanging, it's gotta be past 3, and I've never seen a crescent moon so fine. Somewhere a nightbird's calling, there's a sweet breeze from the sea, and I just can't seem to get you off my mind. What kind of fool am I to go and fall in love with one who's already taken? Why did the good Lord give us hearts when He knew all along they would only end up breaking? each other for eternity. But I gotta do what's right, and that means I can't stay, 'cause there's other folks who need you more than me. What kind of fool am I to go and fall in love with wounds already taken? Why did the good Lord give us hearts when He knew all along they would only end up breaking? From where the stars are hanging, it's gotta be past 3, and I've never seen a crescent moon so fine.
I hope you guys were hearing the harmonies that I was hearing in my and the guitar solo and the flugelhorn, too. I was hearing the flugelhorn. All right, well, so you want to sing along, right?
Yes.
Okay, so here you go. This one's easy. So Barry gave you one where you had to sing two words. Mine only has one word.
What?
Yeah. Well, there's other words in the song, but you only have to sing one. Good. And that word is orthodontia. Another song. Yeah, the funny thing is, all these songs, we're talking words, not syllables. Everybody else is singing these deep songs full of meaning. My songs are all, I'm such a case of arrested development. All of my songs come from about like being like 11 and a half years old. So. And here's one of them. Young, about 12 years old, I was in love, but I wasn't bold. Knew what I wanted, but I could not say it. I just stared at her every day. Her name was Judy, and she was so beautiful, my head would buzz. Stayed up all night under the covers, wondering how to say I love her. Being a girl, she was smarter than me, and Judy knew, yes, she could see that I was helpless, head over heels, in love, in lust, had the fever, had the chills. She'd smile at me just waiting for the words to squeak up out of my vocal cords. Judy was ready to say yes. I couldn't speak my heart, I guess, and Judy's time was mine. Till I started giving her, your part's coming up, a hard time about her orthodontia. Here's where you sing. Orthodontia. Real operatic style.
Orthodontia. Vocabulary, but I was blind, I could not see. Judy was starting to hate me. Now I'm older, now I know how to say what I'm feeling and how to show the contents of my heart to you. But back then I didn't have a clue, and Judy's time was mine till I started giving her
word orthodontia. Anyways.
What does it mean?
Let me demonstrate. You got tools in the car?
No, not anymore.
You used to have orthodontic tools in the... Okay, I don't want to know. I don't want to know, Jim. Anyways.
Field surgeon.
So anyway, here's a song about the most important thing in the world. This one is not a funny song. This is kind of a serious song, but it's kind of short, and it's just a little... Some words of advice for you, words of wisdom, like you need advice from me. It's called Surrender Yourself to Love. I wish I remembered the words to this song. I wrote them so long ago. Something about clouds in a perfect blue sky. Life moving mellow and slow. Might have been a few words about angels smiling down on us from above. But these are the words that I need you to hear. Surrender yourself to love. Take a deep breath. Tune into your mind, heart. Quiet your silly mind. Like Ginsberg said, you're not your skin of grime. You're a sunflower deep inside. Whether you think I'm a fool or a madman or a charlatan or all of the above, but let me suggest you surrender yourself to love. Surrender yourself to love.
So do it.
One more song. Matt, does anybody think, can you play that thing in sort of E minor-ish thing?
I'll try.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, I feel like I could do it in a different...
I'll do it from here.
Okay, great.
No,
all right.
Take a mic. What the hell? Get up there.
Listen to Jim. Come on. No, I want you up here, Barry. I agree with Jim.
Be shy.
Now, my other songs kind of made a little bit of sense. This one doesn't. French telephone. I'm talking, wow. French telephone. Sophisticated French telephone. I'm talking on the phone from France. I'm wearing fancy French pants. If I had a mighty escargot, wash them down with a nice Merlot.
Been there.
Gary Edelman, people.
French telephone. I'm talking on a French telephone. French telephone. Sophisticated French telephone. French telephone. I'm talking on a
everybody, and Music for Humanity. Let it go on for another zillion years. Denise Jordan Finley, Matt Finley, the absent Ron Reninger. Such an amazing, amazing night of music. Thanks for being here. Appreciate it.
Thank you for coming. June 16th, we'll be back again. Appreciate all the donations. Great music. Thank you so much.
Thank you. That was so fun. Thank you.
That was too short.